I'm a bad boy. When I got off my ass and got to the cash and got in my bag, boy.
What's up, y'all? It's Bam. Welcome back to my channel, and I'm just gonna jump straight into this video. So the wig that I'm working with now is a Body Wave 16-inch lace frontal wig, and in today's tutorial, I'm doing a split dye, half red, half black wig. So you see me parting the wig down the middle and putting it into two sections. So the colors I'm going to be using is jet black and ruby red, and I'm basically just dyeing the roots so it can be easier for when I watercolor, because we are watercoloring this wig. So I'm just dyeing the roots, the edges, whatever first, and then we are going to start our watercoloring process. And also, I'm using an edge brush to dye my roots because it's so much easier versus using a regular dyeing brush. It gets the job done faster and quicker. So that's what I'm using to dye my roots. Make sure y'all are careful when dyeing the roots, because as y'all can see, I got a little red on the opposite side, but it's okay because the other color is black that we'll be dyeing, and it's gonna cover that right up. But still, just be really careful. So now I'm starting on the opposite side with the jet black. So I'm just basically doing the same thing that I did with the red side. So a lot of people been asking me, do I do custom wig orders? And the answer is yes, I do custom wig orders. So all you gotta do is DM me on Instagram. My Instagram is at the top of the screen. So just DM me what kind of wig you want and what inch you want, and I will give you pricing and stuff. And I also do provide the hair. So this is how it should look once you did both sides of the wig with your colors. Now I'm going to start the watercoloring process. filled the bin up with hot water from my sink, and the first color I'm going to be dipping is jet black. So put the jet black dye in the bin and mix it up, and then you want to dip the whole half of the wig inside the bin until it completely turns the color that you want, which is jet black. So I'm gonna continue to dip and dip and dip and dip until the whole half of the wig is jet black, basically. So I'm dumping some of the water out because the less water that's in the bin, the more that the dye will take onto the hair. So that's why I emptied out a little bit of water so the dye can like stick onto the hair a little bit more. So once the hair dye is almost gone like this, as you can see, I like to put a little bit of water inside the bottle, just a little bit, and then shake it up, and then that's gonna make more dye for you. If you've been watching my previous videos, then you would know that I do this all the time to get that last little bit of hair dye out that bottle. So I put some new hot water inside the bin, and now we're gonna start with the ruby red color. So I put that in the bin and mixed it up, and I'm basically just dipping the other half of the wig inside the bin, basically just doing the same thing that I did with the black side. And just to let y'all know, I use 3 bottles of the red dye and I use 3 bottles of the jet black to dye this whole wig. So I always let my wigs air dry for 24 hours, and when it dried, I noticed that the red side was a little light and I wanted it a little bit darker. So I'm going in with a crimson red and I'm putting it inside a bucket of hot water, and I'm gonna dip the red side one more time inside the crimson to make it a little bit more darker. So as I'm dipping the hair, I'm gonna take my comb and comb through the hair so the hair dye can distribute evenly throughout the hair. And then after I'm done dipping and dipping and dipping, as y'all can see, I'm going to start the washing process. So after watercoloring the wig, now I'm just rinsing it off just to get all the extra dye off the hair. As y'all can see, a lot of dye is coming off. So you want to do that before washing the hair. And then after I'm done, I'm going to regularly shampoo and condition my wig. And y'all can use any type of shampoo and conditioner you want, but the shampoo and conditioner I recommend is any Shea Moisture brand, because that's just the best shampoo and conditioner when washing your hair. It will leave your wig so silky and so soft. So I didn't have any at the time, so I'm just using the shampoo and conditioner I have in my house right now. But if I did have Shea Moisture, I would be using it on the wig. But just to let y'all know, Shea Moisture is the best brand to use when washing any type of hair. So after shampooing and conditioning, I'm just rinsing the wig off real good, and now I'm detangling the wig just to get any like tangles out. But it was barely any tangles in the wig. I just do that just to do it. So I'm basically done with this tutorial, and this is the finished look. I styled it off camera, but if you guys want to see a tutorial on me styling, then let me know in the comments down below, and I'll see you guys in my next video. No, no, not at all. None of you bitches compare. Nah, try this shit, baby, I dare. Yeah, you gon' be sweating your hair. Tryna catch up to a bitch like me. I-